President Trump defending his decision to sign a series of executive orders. The president signed the orders on Saturday after talks for a broad relief bill between the White House and congressional Democrats fell apart. But Democrats and even some Republicans are blasting the orders, insisting they are neither effective nor legal. Nebraska Republican Senator Ben Sasse said in a statement, the pen and phone theory of executive lawmaking is unconstitutional slop.
I agree with the Republican senator said it was unconstitutional slop.
The orders include a new weekly unemployment bonus payment of $400. That's less than the $600 people were initially receiving and that Democrats have pushed to extend since it expired last month. The order also requires states to contribute $100 of that, something House Speaker Nancy Pelosi says is not possible.
States don't have the money to do that. They have expenses from the coronavirus.
President Trump also announcing a suspension of payroll taxes for people making less than $100,000 a year. The deferred tax would still be owed next year unless Congress agrees to waive it. And that tax funds Social Security and Medicare. But President Trump making this pledge.
This will have no impact on Social Security.
So do you see what that does there? It's a payroll tax cut, which, by the way, in this iteration, disproportionately helps the employer, not the employed, the employee. That does nothing to help the unemployed, by the way. And then it suspends it through the rest of the year after the election, which is key. So it makes a whole mess of the Medicare Social Security system and then says, "Ah, Congress, you'll deal with it after the election. I want to give the illusion that I'm providing temporary relief to help me win the election." And then for all the members of Congress and the senators who then have to take this up, this suspension of the payroll tax cut, it puts them in a terrible position, which is why only 10 Republicans in the Senate supported a payroll tax cut. Because what, are they going to re-implement it and put a tax on people who are already economically struggling because of the depression caused by Trump and his response and the Republicans and the Democrats laying over and playing dead? That's what the position that they're going to be put in by Trump. But he doesn't care. He doesn't care. He only cares about his reelection. And so he doesn't care if he puts Democrats in that position, certainly, or Republicans in that position. And I fear deeply that they won't rise to the occasion. And this begins the slippery slope of privatizing and cutting Social Security and Medicare. So I'm very terrified by that. And when you look at all of these orders themselves, they're nonsensical, they're dangerous, they're flimsy, it doesn't make any sense. And it's also deeply unconstitutional because Congress has the power of the purse and Trump basically circumvented them to push forward his own reelection efforts and didn't wait for a compromise to happen. I thought Republicans cared so, so much about the Constitution. It's pretty clear that the executive branch can't do this. This is where Congress is supposed to be making these laws. The one thing also that's decent in the executive orders that he signed, which who knows if they even have power, was the eviction moratorium. Oh, wow. If you look at that on its face, it sounds like it's a good thing. It's not an eviction moratorium at all. It's just a memo that asks leaders to study if an eviction moratorium is feasible. And that's just the first of many obfuscations in these orders. The United States has about 110 million renters, and many have been hit hard by the layoffs in retail, restaurants, and hospitality during the pandemic. Trump's executive order does little to help them. Trump has said many times in recent days he wants to prevent evictions, but his latest executive order does not ban evictions. Instead, Trump calls for Health and Human Services Secretary Alex Azar and CDC Director Robert Redfield to consider whether an eviction ban is needed. Trump also didn't provide any more money to help renters. The executive order calls only for Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin and Housing and Urban Development Secretary Ben Carson to see if they can find any more funds to help it out. It doesn't promise more aid. Trump also instructed the U.S. Treasury to halt collection of payroll taxes from September 1st through December 31st for workers who earn less than $4,000 every 2 weeks. That's people earning under about $104,000 a year. This will feel like a tax cut for a few weeks because workers will end up with larger paychecks while the tax is not collected, but it is technically a tax deferral, meaning the taxes will still be due at a later date. Payroll taxes help pay for Social Security and Medicare. Trump is attempting to postpone the 6.2% tax that employees pay in every paycheck for Social Security. The United States currently has more than 30 million people on unemployment aid. They have been receiving an extra $600 a week from the federal government on top of their state aid, which averaged $330 a week, but Congress set the federal funding to expire at the end of July. Trump's memo calls for federal aid to restart at the level of $400 a week. But there's a catch. The federal government is only paying for $300 of that. States have to kick in the other $100. Many states are currently cash-strapped as they fight the coronavirus, and there's concern governors won't sign on to do this. So as you can see, he has made a mess of pretty much everything. The only thing that was at least a little bit decent was that he suspended interest payments on student loans. But even that, you don't have the power to do this. And this is not to absolve, like, Obama of doing unconstitutional executive orders. Oftentimes it was to circumvent the Republicans blocking everything, but that was because the Democrats lost their supermajority and didn't make their case. Sad day. We have gone down since the Bush administration, especially, this very dangerous rabbit hole of the executive just doing whatever they want. But this is even more egregious because these are specifically laws that, either or, that Congress should be legislating on. There's just no way that Trump has this power. Congress has the power of the purse. We know this. And hopefully these have no teeth because they make a mess of everything. And that's what Trump does, isn't it? So par for the course, par for the Trump golf course that he's always on.